Here's an overview of some of the things you'll see and learn about in this video. Let's start by reviewing a couple of important terms that you're going to see later on in this video. Phonological awareness is the ability to recognize and manipulate the spoken parts of words and sentences. Phonological awareness includes a lot of more specific skills, which is why it's often shown as an umbrella, with the specific skills underneath the umbrella. Some of these skills include identifying rhyming words, recognizing alliteration when several words all start with the same consonant sound, segmenting sounds in a word, and identifying the syllables in a word. You should also remember that decoding is the ability to convert a word from print to speech using your knowledge of sound-spelling relationships. Now that you've activated that background knowledge that you're going to need, let's define some more complex terms that may be newer to you. The term dysgraphia refers to a variety of difficulties that students may have with transcription skills in writing. Transcription skills include handwriting, typing, and spelling, the physical parts of writing. These difficulties may cause students to write more slowly or write less on their writing tasks. Dysgraphia is not related to a student's cognitive ability or intelligence. Dysgraphia is not related to or caused by a vision problem. Dysgraphia technically refers to just the physical difficulty with transcription, which is that physical part of writing. It's not the same as having trouble with organization or attention or executive function in writing or putting your thoughts into writing. Lastly here, dysgraphia is not included under IDEA as a specific learning disability, although difficulty with oral or written expression is covered, and that's often what we see on IEPs for students with dysgraphia. Now let's take a look at the definition for dyslexia. This definition is adapted from both IDEA and the International Dyslexia Association. Dyslexia is a specific learning disability that is characterized by difficulties with accurate word recognition and decoding, and it's caused by a neurobiological deficit in phonological awareness. Like dysgraphia, dyslexia is not caused by a vision problem, and it is not connected to a person's cognitive ability or their intelligence. But dyslexia is included as a specific learning disability under IDEA. In the rest of this video, we'll take a closer look at how common each of these disability areas are and how they're assessed. Let's look at dysgraphia first. Both dysgraphia and dyslexia appear to run in families, although that isn't the only cause or the only risk factor. Anywhere from 10 to 30% of children struggle with writing at some point in school. If that sounds like a pretty vague number, you are right. Dysgraphia is not well understood yet, not nearly as well as dyslexia, and it can be hard to isolate and identify dysgraphia. One reason why dysgraphia is difficult to identify at times is that even though it can show up on its own, it's much more often seen with one or more other disabilities or difficulties. Dysgraphia often appears alongside attention disorders like attention deficit disorder or attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, or ADD and ADHD. Several people who have dyslexia also have dysgraphia and vice versa. And even though the definition of dysgraphia is about the physical side of writing, it's also common to see it along with other impairments or issues with oral and written language. It can be very difficult to identify a physical problem like dysgraphia that is so closely related to the invisible process of thinking and writing. Because dysgraphia is often an underlying or coexisting issue, it's hard to assess and diagnose whether a student is struggling with organization, attention, and executive function, or with physical transcription, or both. Now let's take a similar look at dyslexia. Medical and education researchers estimate that about 20% of the U.S. population, including children and adults, may show one or more symptoms of dyslexia. Notice that this does not mean that all of those people have a dyslexia diagnosis, just that they have issues with reading that are very similar to people that do have a dyslexia diagnosis. Let's focus more closely on school-age children. About 50% of K-12 students who receive special education services are identified for those services under the specific learning disability category. And about 85% of those students' primary disability area is reading or language processing. This includes, but isn't only made up of, students with dyslexia. Even though dyslexia is included under IDEA as a specific learning disability, there is no federal mandate for dyslexia screening or identification for public school students, although many states have enacted those laws. This means that although IDEA includes dyslexia as an eligibility category for individualized education plans or IEPs, IDEA does not specify how dyslexia should be identified or diagnosed. There are two aspects of dyslexia identification that you should know about. The first one is called universal screening. Just like your doctor would use a screening test to figure out if you are at risk for certain diseases, schools can use a brief, inexpensive, but hopefully evidence-based assessment to screen all of their students for difficulties with reading that may or may not be related to dyslexia or some other reading or print-based disability. It's important to also understand, though, that this is not the same thing as diagnosing dyslexia in an individual student. Diagnosing or determining if an individual person has dyslexia involves a variety of tests that are administered by a variety of people. There may be tests of reading and oral language ability, classroom or one-on-one observations, interviews or surveys with parents and teachers, evaluation by a speech-language pathologist, and possibly other kinds of assessments. So it's clear that this process can often take a long time and can be expensive, not to mention stressful, for the individual and for their parents or caregivers. Universal screening is not a replacement or an alternative to the full diagnostic process for dyslexia, but universal screening in schools, usually around kindergarten through second grade, is one way to identify students who may be at risk for dyslexia or other reading delays or difficulties. You should also know that universal reading screenings are not required by all states or all districts. But universal screening for dyslexia or other reading issues is very important because it means that a student who needs support will get that support earlier. Early intervention for reading disabilities, including dyslexia, is key to ensuring that the student gets the instructional support and accommodations that they need. Once we identify the students who need that instructional support, it's important to pay attention to the science of reading and the latest research evidence in order to fully address those students' needs. Currently, there's an abundance of evidence that shows that structured and explicit literacy instruction is the best way to support struggling readers. In some schools and for some students, that may mean using a specialized program or curriculum like the Wilson Reading System or Orton-Gillingham, in addition to what the school uses in general education for reading. Although students who are struggling with reading or who are at risk for dyslexia definitely need structured literacy instruction, the truth is that all students can benefit from this approach to reading instruction. Structured literacy should include an emphasis on phonics and decoding skills, especially at the younger grades, as well as instruction in other areas of literacy like comprehension and vocabulary. We have covered a lot of material in this video, so let's review before we finish up. By definition, dysgraphia includes difficulties with physical aspects of writing called transcription. This includes handwriting, typing, and spelling. Difficulties with transcription skills can also cause problems or delays in written expression. Dyslexia is a specific learning disability that is characterized by difficulties with accurate word recognition and decoding, and it's caused by a neurobiological deficit in phonological awareness. Neither dyslexia nor dysgraphia are related to a student's cognitive ability, intelligence, or their vision. But dyslexia is included as a specific learning disability under IDEA, where dysgraphia is not. That's all for this video. Thanks again for watching.